We have two waves, y1 and y2. Y1 is traveling to the right and y2 is traveling to the left. Both the waves have equal speed, 3 meter per second, equal wavelength, 2 meters, and equal amplitude of 15 centimeters, or we can write it as 0.15 meters. We are given that y2, the wave which is traveling to the left, is out of phase by positive pi by 6. Let us find out what the resultant wave will be. First, we want to gather more information about the two given waves. So let's find out the wave number, which depends on lambda. Lambda is given as 2, so the wave number 2 pi by lambda will be pi radians per meter. We have the speed as lambda into frequency, and so the frequency will be speed upon lambda. We have the speed given as 3, the wavelength lambda given as 2 meters, so the frequency will be 3 by 2 hertz. And using the frequency, we can find out omega, which is the angular frequency, which is related to the frequency as 2 pi by f, sorry, 2 pi f equal to 3 pi radians per second. Now we have all the information we require to write down the equations for y1 and y2. So writing down the general equation for y1 and y2, y1 is a sine kx minus omega t, and y2 is a sine kx plus omega t plus pi by 6 plus omega t because it's traveling to the left side, and plus pi by 6 is the phase difference between y1 and y2. Now putting down the values for k and omega, we write y1 and y2 as this. Now let's write down the resultant wave. The resultant wave will be simply the addition of the two waves. So the resultant wave will be given by this equation. So these are sine pi by x minus 3 pi t plus sine pi x plus 3 pi t plus pi by 6. See, we are adding two sine waves over here. So if you remember, the formula for addition of sine a plus sine b is 2 sine a plus b by 2 and cos a minus b by 2. So we'll use this formula and apply it to our equation. And we notice that this will be the final expression that we get. Now solving the value inside the brackets, we can write down the expression for the resultant wave y, which has 0.3 sine pi x plus pi by 12 into cos 3 pi t plus pi by 12. Let's use the equation that we got for the resultant displacements to find out the value of y at a given position and time. So let's say x is given as 2 meters and time is given as 3 seconds. And this is the equation for the resultant wave that we derived. So we'll just substitute x equal to 2 and t equal to 3, and we'll find what the value for y is. So substituting x and t, we get this value, and we'll solve further. We'll get 0.3 sine 25 pi by 12 and cos 109 pi by 12. So we'll write pi as 90 degrees over here, and we substitute 90 degree for pi. We'll get the value as sine 187.5 degrees and cos 817.5 degrees. And if you evaluate using the calculator, the final value for y at x equal to 2 and t equal to 3 is 0.005 meters.